their game tomorrow. Frank Reich saying Jacoby Brissett, game time decision. You want to take it all the way up to game day, Sean O'Hara.
Rub some Tiger Balm on that thing.
Yeah. I love Tiger Balm.
Get it.
You love Tiger Balm?
Yeah.
Wow, okay. Go. All right, so.
Hand the ball off to Marlon Mack. Let's roll.
Yeah, what, well, girls can't like Tiger Balm?
No, I thought it was just.
I'm kidding.
I don't know. We're learning a lot about Tiger Balm. We're also learning a lot about Jacoby Brissett, more than just a backup quarterback. We'll see if he's able to play. If not, Brian Hoyer. No T.Y. Hilton, though, for the Colts. James. Okay, that's it. That's all we got, Sean.
Cool. Single back is Darrell Williams. And Mahomes sneaks it, and somebody better guard that ankle.
Oh, no.
As he went on the quarterback sneak, he is down on his left hip, and he has taken his helmet off. They are calling to the sideline.
This is clearly something very bad.
Patrick Mahomes has been declared out for the rest of the game with a knee injury.
This is news not only the Chiefs Kingdom, but throughout the NFL.
All right, just 24 days after dislocating his kneecap, Patrick Mahomes is ready to go. I was about to throw it to James Palmer. That's why I had a humming, a humming, a humming a moment. Now I'm throwing it to James Palmer.
As the Chiefs are wrapping up practice on Friday, I saw two players still on the field working. It was Tyreek Hill catching passes from Patrick Mahomes. Now, Mahomes is back, and he returns against the Tennessee Titans, which was the plan he told me all along. Now, the Chiefs were coy maybe the last 2 weeks, not really telling anyone who their starting quarterback would be, but my understanding was Mahomes was never going to play in either one of those games, and this was always the goal for him, if everything went according to plan. And Mahomes told me it did just that. My understanding is it was because of his tireless work ethic and consulting with two knee specialists along with the Chiefs doctors that gave him the okay to play in this game. Now, Mahomes also told me he's going to be wearing a knee brace on that knee. He told me mainly because of confidence reasons. He said he doesn't really believe he's going to have to wear it as the season goes on, but for right now, he'll be wearing a knee brace in his first game back after dislocating his kneecap just 24 days ahead of that.
James, yeah, all the Twitter MDs, they cleared Mahomes after they saw him celebrating last week.
Yeah.
Here's how the Chiefs offense has looked with and without Mahomes. With him, 29 points per game and over 420 yards of offense. With Matt Moore, they averaged 25 a game and nearly 70 fewer yards of offense. Interesting to note, Casey actually threw the ball more with Moore than they have with the MVP.
Interesting.
So what does all of this mean? Of course, they're a better team with Patrick Mahomes, What are the expectations for Mahomes now?
I expect Patrick Mahomes, the Patrick Mahomes that you're used to seeing. I expect that mobility. I mean, that's what they were looking at in practice the last couple of weeks, to see if he could move around, and that was going to be the go-sign. He actually looked good last week, but they, like Mahomes said to James Palmer yesterday, there was a certain amount of time that they were going to wait no matter what, and this was the game that really they were always eyeing. So I don't expect him to be limited. He's going to be wearing that brace, but it's something that he's just wearing to kind of get used to, like James had mentioned here. So I expect to see 100% Mahomes.
Look, I mean, we're watching a video right now of him warming up, and that's great and everything. But, D-Hall, you know about this. It's not the controlled movements that worry you. It's what happens when you're in the pocket, and all of a sudden you got to scramble. There's an unblocked defender. Now you've got to react, and it's not an unscripted movement. So I think that first drive, all eyes are going to be on Mahomes. Mm-hmm. But if I'm Mike Vrabel, I'm coming after him. I'm sending a blitz. I'm going to send a cowboy blitz. Hey, D-Hall, you got the green light, man. Go ahead.
Yeah.
Bring him from the back. And let's flush him out. Let's make him think about that knee early on, and let's test it and find out if he is mobile.
Maybe he was watching me, and I just told him he's going to be fine, and he just said, you know what, scrap all these blitzes.
I think Mike Vrabel knows better than us.
Okay, all right.
So he's going to say, I'm going to find out for myself. So I'm curious to see on that first drive if they blitz him, how often they blitz him, try to make him move around. And then the other thing that will tell me a lot is, where is Mahomes? Is he in shotgun the whole time? Because if he is, that means that they don't want to put him underneath. Uh-huh. They don't want him to have to come back on the 5-7-7 drop and not put all that pressure on the knee.
Yeah, how Andy Reid calls this game will be interesting, too. I mean, will he be in max protect, kind of like what they did with Matt Moore? And just to kind of protect that is...
There might be 100 screens.
Right, that's
true. In this game. Andy Reid loves some screens.
The strength of the Titans' defense is that pass rush, so they got to protect him.
Yeah, they got to protect him. We know the strength of Tennessee is the pass rush. We know Mike Vrabel definitely is going to try to rush Pat Mahomes. So what do you do if you're Andy Reid and Pat Mahomes? You run the football. We hear Mike Robb say week in and week out, Andy Reid has to run the football. I think this is the week that he runs the football, because to Sean's point, we got to protect Patrick Mahomes from himself. Like, if we hope to be where in this playoff picture, at the end of the year, we need Pat Mahomes healthy, right? Yes. If we know he's playing in this game, let's run the football a little bit more. Let's protect him a little bit more. Let's not drop back and throw the ball as much as we have in the past. Let's just try to get a rhythm for this offense. And so I think this actually helps them, having Pat Mahomes a little bit banged up. Or not 100%, because I don't care what he says, he's not 100%. Does he feel good? Absolutely. We've all been there to where, look, coach, I feel good enough, I can go. I can give you what we need to win a game. But like Sean said, it's those unscripted plays. It's that dude coming in, you know, those movements that he does is just so spur of the moment, not planned. And rehab is all planned movements. Mm-hmm. When you're out there on the field, who knows what can happen.
No doubt he'll have Tiger Balm on. Yeah, he's going to have
That's
it.
That's true.
Yes,
very true.
He will.
But, I mean, this is a game, too, where the Titans defense, the back end is banged up, too. We saw what Kyle Allen and the Panthers were able to do. So let's see now what Mahomes and this Chiefs offense can do. Because now that they lost Malcolm Butler, you have, who do they have it there? LaShawn Sims is going to be covering one side.
If so, you got to look at the card.
Hey, LaShawn, I'm sorry, LaShawn.
So, no, you know what? My bad. It's not a knock.
Yeah,
no, but it's true. I mean, Patrick Mahomes, you know he's going to go out there and just light it up.
Yeah, it's a game of
matchups. Okay, so we're on the same page. These guys want to see if he's really 100%.
Yeah.
I believe in you, Patrick.
We all believe in you.
Mahomes at 80% is still better than a lot of guys.
That's a great point.
Yeah.